Welcome to today's video. Make sure you visit podcastformarketers.com for more information. Over there, I have a really kick-ass course on how you can make at least a few grand a month on simple reoccurring revenue, right? And that's called Freedom Funnels. And make sure that you like this video and subscribe to my channel, man. I'm put out videos every day, so you don't want to miss what I put up, because I put out some pretty kick-ass content. And man, I always want you guys to comment below, man. I love, absolutely love all the comments you guys bring. Let me know what you're thinking. If you have any questions, I'm always in the comment section. I really love the community. Let's get into the video. All right, guys, so today's video is about landing pages. Now, we're going to talk about Landingi for today. The first thing I want you to understand is that landing pages don't have to be pretty, right? So I want to show you very quickly here that I'm getting a 58 or just about a 58% conversion rate here. Actually, it was 58%. I must have had a couple of visits, right? But I'm getting a 58% conversion rate on a very simple landing page, right? And here's what the landing page looks like, okay? And I can easily get more conversions on this. I can go above 58%. If I was to add my my YouTube, Instagram photo here, or podcast marketers for a little bit of branding, this terms and service down here, a no spam policy, perhaps. There's a few things, and maybe even a testimonial here would probably jack up a good 2%. But I'm enjoying a 57.41% conversion rate. Now, I wanted to show you that this is a lead magnet for just a list, okay? A very simple lead magnet for a list. Now, here's the difference between what your conversion rates can look like. So here is a video series opt-in. Now, I've had more visits, and it's a 21.51% lead conversion rate, okay? Now, why am I seeing a conversion rate much lower than what I am? Because this is more of and this is the same page, okay? And this is more of a commitment, a video series. You know, is it, you know, how long is it going to be? Is it hours and hours and hours? Do I have time for this? Is it going to be live? There's not very much information. The one thing that I like about Landingi is that I can split test. So I'm going to start split testing and making new landing pages and split testing and making a variant. Now that I have some data on hand on, you know, a few people that have come through and I've had a few conversions and a few visits, I can start running data to get to bump this up, right? Either one of these can be bumped up very simply, but I wanted to show you how simple it is, and it doesn't have to be, you know, over the top, right? Just a simple curiosity-based headline. And a simple, and I did change the pop-up here to be a little bit more attractive to see if I could try, just see if I could bump up the conversion rates a little bit. Okay, so on the other one that, and I can show you that really quickly, it's even simpler than that, man. I mean, this thing is super simple. It's just boom, put your email address in, and that's a done deal. Okay. So, and I'm enjoying a really high conversion rate with that. Now, I wanted to show you as well as what your funnel would look like, because Facebook doesn't like landing pages anymore. They want the customer to have, or their people to have, some type of user experience. Okay. They want to know that they're leaving Facebook. If they're going to leave Facebook, they're going to have, and it's really kind of like a Gestapo move, man. It's almost like some Nazi shit, but it's like, you know, if they're going to leave off of our platform, you have to make sure they're having a good experience. Hey man, once they're gone, they're gone. Facebook is a trip, man. So I wanted to show you that here on my blog that I have a very simple call to action, right? Another, and this is what you should be doing in your blogs. Now, I want you to see how simple this blog is. There's no distractions. There's no click here. As a matter of fact, my menu is hidden over here. You can't hardly see my menu, right? It's just a simple, this is actually a, I post my emails a day on my website, but I also posted up a YouTube video here, okay? But you see, there's a very simple call to action in the middle. I am enjoying a 15.48% conversion click-through rate. I can also A-B test this as well between two different calls to action, which I haven't done yet. Haven't gotten enough data yet. I want to add a little bit more data to this. And I'll probably just put an ad up on Facebook to get a little bit more data with this. And then I'll start A-B testing. But right now, a 15.48% conversion rate isn't bad. On this little, ugly, simple call to action, why does this work? Well, first of all, it's relevant with my content, right? And what I'm talking about here, because I'm always talking about reoccurring revenue and earning, you know, passive income. All right, so that's recurring and that's relevant to my content. The next thing is there's no distractions on the page. Again, if you notice, there's no distraction here. I could add a little bit more proof here to probably bump up the conversions on these pages, but they're really simple, kind of like, and where I stole this design from was just my page takeover that I have on everything, on the other, my, on all of my other websites. I have a page takeover that looks exactly like this, and I enjoy 25 to 28% conversions. No distractions. It's just a simple blog post, right? So you can see why. I mean, they only have one thing to look at. Give me your email address or keep reading, and then that's it. And maybe perhaps they'll get nosy and want to read more things on my blog, okay? And I wanted to show you again. Now, here is something that's cute that gets shitty conversion rates. I've had over 900 visits on this now, and I'm only gotten 2.7% conversion rate, and I'll show you what that looks like right now. And it's not kind of the same thing. It's one of these little bars that kind of pops up. Again, you guys have seen this page that I put it on Mautic, and then you see here just a little pop-up thing comes up, and you give me your name and your email address, right? 2.7% conversion rate, crappy, right? So another thing I'll tell you about is an entire page takeover does better. These little bars and slide-ins from the bottom and all that stuff is not going to enjoy a conversion rate like a call to action will on a, like, you just have this video. They're going to watch the video more than be concerned about. If I gated this video, number one, I would get a lot more. Or if I just did a whole page takeover first. Just boom, just a whole welcome mat, right? Would get a better conversion rate. I just want to kind of show you the difference in these little tools that you'll see online. Now, I bought this. I paid for the lifetime license on this, and I use it with ThriveCart. It works really good with ThriveCart. People come in and they want to see if they can get a discount after about 30 seconds. If they're like on the fence about buying my products, I'll pop up a discount. These bars and notifications work really well for that. But as far as trying to collect leads from the site, you're going to need something more like this, you know, where that's all the, this is the only thing that's on the page, and this is what they're there for, and you're just running traffic to this alone, right? And if you have a page takeover, which we already talked about, you can do in Mautic, this is kind of what you want them to see. Just an entire page takeover with curiosity-based. And honestly, the you'll get more leads with this a document or a checklist, but the quality of the lead will not be as good as people that want to come in and see an entire video series. And the only reason I can tell you this is because I know my squad members, and I can see that I have some people, some names that I recognize in the leads. And I know that these are good quality leads, people that want to, that are interested in my content and interested in taking a class from me, right? And then these are new people that are coming in for the niches that I'll have to nurture a little bit, and the lead quality may not be as good, right? But I'm getting more of those leads. And 58%, guys, I really want to kind of push that over the edge and talking to you. Now, I'm going to start doing this Landingi series, so I want you to stay tuned, because I'm going to do more of these. But showing you how to make these pages really is a kind of a no-brainer, but I am going to walk through how to do pop-ups and how to do an actual funnel for your recurring revenue. Coffee break. Ah.